Wow. You wouldn't believe this wasn't meat. The texture is amazing. This can make the barbecue. Hey you all, welcome to the Mindful Plate. If you want to get straight to the jerk jackfruit kebabs recipe, then go here. If you want to know why I stopped making these with chicken and started subbing with jackfruit, then stick around.
Hey, I'm your host, Shelley Wellness. I'm on this journey to elevate our consciousness around food, and I invite you to join me. On this channel, I'll share recipes created with mindfulness, rooted in wellness. Welcome to the Mindful Plate.
Growing up, I didn't care for the taste of meat. I just cared that it was well seasoned, fried, grilled, barbecued, or covered in a rich, flavorful sauce. So you'd never catch me eating a steak medium rare. Instead, I enjoy dishes like jerk chicken, oxtails, curry goat, griot, Nigerian stew, egusi, lamb tagines, dorowa, souvlaki, muketa, shakshuka, escovitch, divi. That was my vibe. You feel me? That was my vibe. I enjoyed the fullness and the roundness that meat brought to a dish. And eating these dishes always left me feeling satiated and warm and energized. But over time, as I learned about our current food system and what's happening in our meat supply, I found myself wanting to eat less and less of it. I'm at a point now where I don't even want to eat meat sold in the United States because I don't find their standards meet mine. But I'm not here to promote veganism or tell you to stop eating meat. I can't even say that if I went home to Jamaica, I would turn down my family's offering of oxtails and curry goat in love. You see, I get that food is more nuanced. And I also get that our decisions have value, especially when it comes to food. The goal is not to be a vegan. The goal is to elevate our ingredients and eat in a way that is mindful and sustainable. And wildly enough, even with this knowledge, I still want to eat meat sometimes, y'all. So, to ensure that in a moment of weakness, I don't revert back, I created meaty plant-based replacements. I've tried the gamut from soy, veggie chunks, tofu, and mock meats. And some of them come pretty close to texture, but I don't do well with soy and large amounts of gluten. So instead, I turn to meaty veggies, things like mushrooms, nuts, seeds, olives, artichokes, jackfruit, hearts of palm, beets, and banana leaf. They go a long way in giving a recipe the mouthfeel of meatiness. And once the seasoning is done well, you can create anything. So in today's episode, we are going to make these meaty jerk jackfruit kebabs inspired by a blog I read, Vegan Reach.
So we're going to start with washing and rinsing our jackfruit to get rid of that brine solution and discard any seeds. You want to take your time here and go through each piece and begin to take out the seeds. As you take out the seeds, it will naturally start to shred and you'll be left with a texture that very much looks like shredded chicken. Once you have your jackfruit rinsed, you're going to add it to a pot with water and bring to a boil over medium heat for about 6 minutes. Once it starts to boil, you're going to cook it for another 6 to 7 minutes. The idea is to get the texture soft and chewy, as if it were meat.
Perfect.
Once the texture reaches your liking, remove the jackfruit from the heat and drain. If you find any more seeds or rough bits, discard them and set aside. Now we want to roast our chickpea flour. This is going to develop flavor as the heat is going to bring it out. In a large skillet, dry roast 1 cup of chickpea flour over medium-low heat for about 7 to 8 minutes, and you're going to stir it every 2 minutes. You don't want to put this on and leave it, y'all. This part requires you to be super present. You want the chickpea flour to develop a strong, nutty flavor and a brown color. This flavor is going to support all the spices we're going to be adding in a bit. And you can see how the chickpea flour begins to change color as it deepens and darkens. Here, if you look on the spatula, you'll see how light it was when it first started as compared to the deep brown of it towards the end. And once it's all done, just remove it from the heat and set aside. So to a large mixing bowl, you're gonna add your jackfruit. You can shred it some more at this point, but if it's perfect as it is, then leave it. Now it's time to add in your seasoning. So you're gonna add in your grated garlic, your grated ginger, your minced scallion, and your wet jerk seasoning. Now at this point, it's not real meat, so you can taste it and see if the seasoning hits the spot. You want the seasoning to kind of be overpowering at this point. You want it to be like, wow. Because once you add your roasted chickpea flour, it's gonna balance it out. You're gonna add in your 3/4 cup of chickpea flour and you're gonna mix as well. It may be helpful to oil your hands. Now at this point, it should come together kind of like a dough. Not too wet, not too dry. If it's too wet, you're gonna add 1 tablespoon at a time of the roasted chickpea flour. And if it's too dry, you're gonna add a little water. Begin shaping these either into round balls or kind of cube-like shapes. Once you have it shaped, you can bake or you can fry these. I choose to fry because I like the texture it creates for these jerk jackfruit kebabs. Y'all, if this is sounding good so far and looking good so far, give this video a like. We appreciate it, and so does the algorithm. Yellow bell peppers and red onions because their sweetness will balance out the heat and the jackfruit. So you're going to take your bite-sized yellow bell peppers and red onions and lightly saute them in a pan. We want these to have a bit of a bite and a softness at the same time, as if they had been grilled. Now once your veggies are cooked and your jerk jackfruit is cooked, you're ready to skewer these and make your kebabs. Now y'all know how I like to maximize my flavor, so I'm gonna add a bit more sauce and then garnish. You can garnish with whatever you have on hand. Cilantro, parsley, green onion, whatever. And there you are, jerk jackfruit kebabs. The texture is amazing. The jackfruit gives it the shreds like it's chicken. It's wow. And of course, you already know the seasoning is on point. Yes, please. It's so good. Ooh. I love it when I impress myself like this. It's so good. Hey, if you like today's recipe, then hit the like button. And if you're interested in cooking where recipes are a guide, ingredients are intuitive, process is present, and food is always delicious, then subscribe to our YouTube channel and our newsletter. The link is in the description below, or we'll send you the recipe. Take care. I'll see you next time.